Hi, it's Thomas Dolby here. I was very saddened to hear of the death of the wonderful Japanese musician, composer, my friend Ryuichi Sakamoto. And for Ryuichi's fans and friends and family, I thought I would just share some reminiscences I have of my time with Ryuichi, short though it was. I first met him in about 1981. Japanese pop music was becoming popular for the first time in the UK, and the Japanese singer Akiko Yano was touring in the UK, and I was in the middle of recording my album The Golden Age of Wireless, and I had a song that needed a female vocal on it, and I thought that Akiko would be great, and so I got in touch with her and invited her down to the studio in London when I was recording. And she came with a small entourage and introduced them to me in the control room, and one of them she introduced as Luigi. And I thought it was kind of unusual to come across a Japanese guy with an Italian name. Akiko and I went out into the studio, and I showed her on the piano the backing vocal part that I wanted her to do, which was actually quite complicated, tight harmonies, just a sort of doo-wop type thing. And I showed her on the piano what the five-part harmonies would be and said we'd break them down and you know, record them separately. And the part was something like this. And Akiko listened to this and said, well, I think the best thing would be if Luigi wrote it down on a sheet of music paper for me. And so she called Luigi from the control room, and Luigi came out, and without batting an eyelid, he played this straight back to me, etc., exactly the way I'd played it by ear. And I was kind of amazed by this, and I thought, well, who is this guy? And I'm going, oh, Luigi, okay, Ryuichi is the way that we pronounce his name. So I stayed in touch with him, and a few years later, in I think late 1984, he actually approached me to add a vocal and a lyric to a song that he'd been working on with some friends. He just had a sort of a groove, and he wanted to add a vocal on top of it. So he sent me the backing track in London, and I wrote the song, which is called Fieldwork, sent him a demo of it, and we agreed that we would meet up to record the vocal. And he was in Tokyo, I was in London, so we agreed to meet in New York City. And we both flew into New York City, and we were both booked into the Midtown Hilton under assumed names. And so we realized, having got there, we had no way of getting in touch with each other. And so each of us called our respective rock music manager in London or Tokyo, and they communicated and put us in touch with each other. We went into the studio and recorded the song. I suppose maybe 6 months after that, we met again in Los Angeles to shoot the music video for the song Fieldwork. And I'll add the link to that on YouTube after this message. I've seen him once or twice since then. This was a man who was an incredible, gentle, intelligent, brilliant musician, fantastic technique on the keyboard, amazing student of classical compositions, amazing film score writer. Obviously, Merry Christmas, Mr. Lawrence is his classic, but he won an Oscar along with David Byrne for The Last Emperor. And I now teach film music at Peabody in Baltimore, and we very often talk about that score. So yeah, those were some reminiscences. I will miss Ryuichi, and for those people that are fans of his, I hope this has been a nice little anecdote.